So you can see here the distal portion of the humerus and then the two bones of the forearm. So here we have our ulna and our radius. The radius is going to be laterally located, thumb side. So we always want to assume the anatomical position, which is where our thumbs are pointed away from our body. And so here we have the radius, okay, of our arm. Now there's a part of the radius we definitely want to look at, and it's this most proximal part closest to the body, and this is called the head of the radius, the head of the radius. And it articulates with the capitulum of the humerus, and the head of the radius and the capitulum of the humerus would articulate like this, and it would enable our elbow to rotate. So it would enable our elbow to rotate like this. And then here we have our ulna, which is our medial bone. And our ulna tells us which bone it is because if you can see it, I'm just going to turn it sideways. You can actually see that it has the letter, its first letter of its name in its structure. So you can see that looks a little bit like a U. So this is the ulna. And the ulna, this is the proximal part of the ulna and the distal part of the ulna. And the proximal part of the ulna that we're going to look at is called the trochlear notch. And you can see this trochlear notch here. And that trochlear notch of the ulna articulates with the trochlea of the humerus and enables the elbow to bend and straighten like this. So again, here we have the ulna and the trochlear notch. And an important part of the trochlear notch of the ulna is if we're going to rotate this around. So now we're looking at the back part of the ulna. And you can see that at the tip of the, at the most proximal part of the trochlear notch, there's this sort of rounded part. This is called the olecranon process, the olecranon process. And it actually is when you think about your putting your elbows on the table, this is usually what bony part you're actually putting on the table. This is the, if you were to say, if we were to ask you to point to your elbow, this is probably the part you're actually pointing to, the olecranon process. And you can see it's the back part, the posterior part of the ulna. I'm going to rotate it back. And again, here you can see sort of the tip of that olecranon process and the trochlear notch that articulates with the trochlea of the humerus to enable my elbow to bend and straighten. Here we have the shaft, body, or diaphysis of the ulna. And then here we actually have the head of the ulna. And the head of the ulna actually forms, if you look at the back of your wrist and you're looking at the pinky side and you see that kind of bumpy part right before where it hits your palm, what you're actually seeing is the head of the ulna. And if we put these back down together, it might be worth noting that the head of the radius and the head of the ulna are on opposite sides. So the head of the radius is at the elbow, proximal, and the head of the ulna, so here's the head of the radius, and the head of the ulna is actually at the wrist and articulates with the bones of the wrist.